Hi everyone, my name is Alexandra Hudson, curator of Civic Renaissance, an intellectual community dedicated to the wisdom of the past, beauty, goodness, and truth. I am here today in front of Nashville's Parthenon, an exact replica of the original Parthenon built by Pericles in 5th century Greece, 5th century BC in ancient Greece. And being here at the Parthenon has caused me, as a student of history and especially a lover and a student of classical history, to think about what the symbol of the Parthenon stands for, both this Parthenon and the last one. And it's really made me reflect on the duality of symbols like this. Just like the duality of humanity, symbolizing the best and the worst, the good and the bad. So for example, Pericles built the original Parthenon by redirecting funds from the Delian League to build it. The Delian League was this loose kind of alliance between Greek city-states that it was a kind of a mutual defense fund, but Pericles took money from that fund and built the Acropolis, built the Parthenon, that was meant to symbolize all things great about Athens: democracy, freedom, equality, kind of all of the ideals of ancient democracy. And that's a beautiful thing. That's something still we benefit from today, that early development of the democratic tradition. Yeah, at the same time, because Pericles redirected these funds, the rest of the Greek city-states weren't thrilled about that, and it was actually a main contributing factor to the outbreak of the Peloponnesian War that was between Greece and other city-states that lasted for 30 years and ended in the destruction of Athens. It was never the same after the Peloponnesian War. So the original Parthenon has a certain duality about it. This Parthenon behind us, it was built originally was built as part of the World's Fair. It was part of Tennessee, of Nashville's desire to show to the world that it was more than just a state that was agrarian, that was based on slavery. It was in the post-Civil War era. And that it declared itself the Athens of the South, that it really wanted to premise its new identity on education, equal opportunity. And that's interesting because on one hand, this Parthenon was built out of a cultural desire to show, okay, we are the best, we are the most civilized, and it was out of this historic notion of Southern chivalry that was premised on a caste system and frankly white supremacy, which is not a great part of legacy and of the legacy of either the South or America. But at the same time, in declaring that Nashville and Tennessee would be the Athens of the South and put it in attaching their horse, so to speak, to higher education, they created an incredible network of higher education institutions and have some of the best and most historically black colleges in the country. Fisk University, for example, incredibly well respected even to this day. So it kind of had a rising tides lifts all boats kind of mentality. And so again, we see the duality, good and bad, in both the original Parthenon and this one behind me. So it causes us to think today, what does this history mean? What do we do with it? How can we have the moral fortitude to condemn the past, but also condemn the injustices in our past, but also learn from them, and frankly, celebrate the good in our past as well? It's difficult. We like simple stories of good and bad, good and evil, but the truth is, truth like humanity is more nuanced and far more complex than either purely good or purely bad. And being here, it gives us a chance to reflect on that. So thank you. I'd like to hear what you think, though. How should we approach these questions in our past and as they reflect our present? And what responsibility do we have today as Americans with things like this, things like slavery and racial injustice in our past? What obligations do we have today to be a part of a more just and equal future? And how can we celebrate the good while condemning the bad and be a part of a better solution today? So we'd love to hear from you, and thanks for being part of the Civic Renaissance community.